Okay, guys, welcome to the course. So this is the course I told you on which teach you cryptocurrencies for beginners. So I gave you the outline of the course, everything we'll be learning in the course, from the negatives and how to avoid them, how cryptocurrency works, the features of cryptocurrency. I'll be showing you different hurdles, and then what are cryptocurrency and your business with them. I will be telling you the blockchain, what is blockchain, and the real world application of it. And then discussing things like achieving consensus or agreement in the system. And then we're talking about different stuff, ICOs, masternodes, security and best practices, the sharing economy. We'll be talking about the technical side of it. And then the last thing we'll be talking about is how to make money. So some of you might be wondering, why are you saying the last thing of it we'll be talking about is how to make money? Now, I tell people, the money is not the very first thing you should seek. The first thing you should seek in anything you do is, how do I get the right knowledge to be able to make use of the little I have? Because the proverb that says the fool and his money are soon parted, it's still relevant for today. Because though we live in a world where different computers are interconnected together, where you have the internet, and basically a net of computers connected together, you will still discover that there is still a lot of noise. How do you filter this noise? How do you filter all these, let me call them sounds? How do you filter what is called communication or a message from noise? So how do you filter all these stuff? That's one of the things we're talking about, the negative. So some of you might be hearing that about Bitcoin or cryptocurrencies or whatsoever. Now the first thing you could have heard was someone saying, I bought maybe Bitcoin for $100 and now it is maybe $11,000 or whatsoever. Who's getting this stuff? I want to get into this stuff. No. I must get into this stuff. How can I not be making money with this? Oh, I must get into this stuff. Oh, I must marry this year. I must do this year. And the basic things and not really taught on how certain things work, what gives the value, these things are not taught. So you might have heard of the negatives in the space. And then the other thing again is, my aware is fraud or scams. So maybe you might have heard that people were defrauded with Bitcoin. Maybe someone bought Bitcoin online and saw a website and paid money to buy Bitcoin and never got the Bitcoin. Or someone wanted to sell his Bitcoin and never. Maybe you might have heard those stories, or you might have heard stories of people who set up websites. And they say, maybe they call them high-yield investment program. So high-yield investment program. That, okay, give us such and such amount of money, and we'll give you such and such amount of money in maybe definite amount of time. And you just, maybe some, you heard someone who gave them money and they run away and they shut down the website. So that is one of the stuffs. Those are the negatives you might have heard about this space. However, we'll keep exploring them. Even if this has a negative, as we will see towards in the course of the course, you will discover that maybe there is more to it. But I don't just want to bring those stuff to you. And then the other thing you might have seen about the negative thing about the space is that there is more to lies. Oh, if you go on YouTube, someone says, how to make millions with such and such and shows. And the question is, when I read a book one time. It's called The 100 Absolutely Unbreakable Laws of Business and Success. I'm a kind of person that I like reading. It's my initial read, apply, and the rest of them. So, Brian Tracy was talking about he had a friend when he was talking about in the law of 100 laws of absolutely unbreakable laws of business success. He talks about the different parts from investing, finance, selling, the law of the customer, the law of time, and the rest of them. So, when he was talking about investing, he was talking about investigating, that I had a friend. If someone come, maybe he's a broker, and says, I could help you invest in money and give you good returns such and such amount of time. He says, okay, let's discuss. He says, okay, bring me your sheet. You said you've been an investor for a while, right? I need proofs. He brings his sheet. Okay. How much did you start with? This is not something like Baba. He wants to see records. He wants to see written records. He wants to see that this record are not something that are forged. Oh, okay. By the time he goes through this fellow who is claiming that he can make him money, or claiming that this investment could make him money, he says, okay, yeah, I'm convinced. I'll give him my money. If he's not convinced, this guy cannot do anything with his money, he will not even bother with investment. So in the space, there are a lot of lies. People, now the lies works with a human needs. Or you can call these lies, the people tailor these lies to the human desires. I won't call it needs, human wants or desires. Is that the people who say, okay, I'm giving away such and such free amount of money, and I am making such amount. I bought a house with Bitcoin, I did this with Bitcoin, I was in debt, and now Bitcoin. And they're like, just all they're talking about, all the focus is money, 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 money. And you're like, wait. Is this only money? Now, I want to ask you a question. If someone comes to you, let's put away Bitcoin, and knocks on your door and says, knock, 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 and says, okay, hello, how are you? So, yeah, my name is Mr. So-and-so. I could make you some money. I'm making some money with such and such stuff. The question is, how are you going to see such a person? Maybe he came to you with real estate. Or maybe he came to you with, maybe you could make money if you have a school. Or maybe you could make money if you're in a transport, in the transportation business. Or you could make money if you're in the hospitality business, like having a hotel or, like Airbnb and the rest of them. If all you talk about is money, you're like, it's in our nation as humans to be very, very careful. And we would not like to hear, even though we need money, even though we need money to transact our daily lives, we would not like to hear what the people have to say, even though what they have to say is very, very good. So money is not the first thing that should be talked about in this space. And then the other negative thing about the system is the issue of impatience. There are people, the stock market, though I don't trade stock, but I know a lot of stocks, about stocks. Let me assume that the stock market gives, if you invest a certain amount of money, it gives you times 2 in a year. People still keep their money there. My boss told me that he has made a commitment to always be investing, I think, whether $100 or a certain percent of his money into the stock market. And this person is patient. He was telling me a time that there was a certain a company he wanted to invest in. And he was very hesitant to invest. And now that company, when he was telling me, I think that was in the beginning of the year, last year, he said, as at the moment we're talking, the stock price for that company he wanted to invest in is already 3 times more than when he wanted to invest. And people are patient. But when you come to the cryptocurrency market, there are certain investments you could make. Maybe in the course of a year, you could get 10 times return. You get maybe 20 times return. But people say no. Why? Because there are flashy things outside. They're always flashy. Oh, someone is saying this. And by the time people start chasing shadows, they start losing time. Not only do they start losing time, they start losing money. And by the time they've lost everything they have, maybe they are forced to start from zero, or even from minus, meaning debt. That is when they begin to seek that this little I have, I need to make wise use of it. Sometimes I'm no longer in some Facebook groups. I don't think these guys are genuine, but you see these guys talking about, hello guys, I have such amount of money. Like someone says, I have $1,000 to invest. Give me advice and the rest of the people always say, okay, really, where can I put the money in the short term? I can enter this. Most of the times I comment, I say, go and study. When you study and come home or back, after you finish studying, maybe 1 week or 2 weeks, or you take a course like this, just put $100 that you have carefully investigated into some of the investments there, and then just be patient. So in the space, there is no patience. In the space, people are always they're always freaking out. Maybe the prices are maybe crashing down. They're like, hey, as if the whole world wants to end. So people are not really patient in the space. So that is one of the problems in the space. The number two problem in the space is the issue of ignorance. Now, when I said the issue of ignorance is, maybe someone might have told you that, oh, they make money with Bitcoin. Okay, how do I go about it? What the faith will tell you, the faith will tell you how this thing works. Is this thing legit? Is this thing, according to religion, is it something that my religion forbids, or my Christian beliefs, or whatever religion you practice, does it forbid it? They don't teach you these things. They don't teach you that, does the government, is it something that is against the government, in the sense that the government, does the government outlaw this stuff? What is the stance of the government? What is the stance of the law on this stuff? They don't teach you, okay, this is blockchain technology, or this is cryptocurrencies, Bitcoin, or whatsoever, and technology. Okay, how does it work? They don't teach you that stuff. Everything they teach you, okay, get $100. Oh, just get in the amount. Sign up. Open this wallet, and you start, just put your money, and you start making money. So there is much ignorance in the space. The economic side of it is not taught as to what gives Bitcoin value. Is Bitcoin a unit of account? Can we really say from the school of thought, is Bitcoin a unit of account? We don't come and say, okay, is it a medium of exchange? Is it something that, is it a store of value? They're talking about the economic side of it. Then you talk about the technological part of it, or the cryptographic part of it. Is this thing safe? Can my Bitcoin be stolen? Because we're in a digital world. So, and then you don't talk about, okay, how do I make the most of my money? How do I avoid scams? How do I avoid people who are with, how do I avoid certain mistakes that go in the space? So there is a lot of mistakes in this. These are some of the negatives in the space. People are always screaming money, and knowledge is not talked about. And the another thing I want to talk about is the government and then the fake news. Currently, before you begin, Bitcoin is in two dimensions. Some government acknowledge it, like the US, they say, okay, if you're trading Bitcoin, we acknowledge Bitcoin to be a kind of legit. Okay, if you're trading Bitcoin, you will pay tax, like those who trade stock and other stuffs. Some government says, no, we're not, Bitcoin is this, no. Or the technology. So you want to check with the government, and what is the government saying? Sometimes the government paints this stuff black. And then another thing again is the fake news, in the sense that sometimes the media creates hype. The media tells you what you want to hear. Because sometimes the government works with the media, and then the government tells you what you want to hear. Then another problem is the issues of bank. Banks offer some negative thoughts. Some banks says, oh, you can buy Bitcoin with this and this and that. So guys, I hope you've been able to understand everything I needed to say about the negatives in the space and how to avoid them. So in the next video, we're talking about how cryptocurrency works. So we'll be talking about what is cryptocurrency, how does it work, the use, and a lot of stuff.
So guys, do have a very good day.